When I watched some Czechoslovak M-10 assembly videos on YouTube, I came across incorrect guides spiced up with false information about the mask or the filters. In order to set the record straight, I decided to make the correct assembly guide true to the original Czechoslovak Army manual describing how to operate the M-10 gas mask. For the purposes of this video, we are going to assemble the upgraded M-10M variant, which features a fluid intake system and is made of more resilient materials when it comes to lenses and the exhale chamber. Also, inlet valves are slightly different when it comes to their construction. Note that this is only an assembly video guide, so if you'd like to know more about M-10's technical parameters and learn more about the mask's history, we'll talk about that in the upcoming episode of History of MBC Unit Series. Factory sealed M-10 gas masks always came in a disassembled state and it was up to the soldiers to put them together. There is the face piece, a pair of vacuum sealed cheek filters, a pair of inlet valves, protective outserts, and in case of the M-10M also a drinking adapter for the army canteen. At the end of this video, we'll also explain what this mysterious thing serves for. We'll start off with the filters unpacking. The text on the label says, cheek filter LF-10M, left insert and right insert, respectively. The lower text says, open the packaging only before inserting, protect from mechanical damage. What's interesting is other M-10 filters always came with this plastic filter plug, which is absent in case of these ones for some reason. Remember that M-10 filters need to be inserted to their designated sides. You can't insert a right cheek filter into the left side of the facepiece. Before we attempt to insert the filters, first we need to unfasten both bottom head harness buckles. This creates the much needed space to fit the filters in. Once unfastened, pull the head harness over the front so we can access the inside of the mask without any limitations. Make sure the filter pockets buttons are undone, as well as the buttons fixing the oronasal cup in the position. Double check whether the filter you're about to insert is the correct side by simply holding it over the face piece. Now, the real struggle can begin. The filter is inserted into a filter pocket with the pointed side first, and once it's fully inserted in the pocket, the filter is directed to its final position from the outside of the facepiece. Make sure the filter thread part fits tightly against the round opening. Now, screw in the first inlet valve to secure the filter in its place. Fasten the two cheek pocket buttons. Now, we repeat the same process with the second filter. Insert it fully into a filter pocket and set its position so you can screw the second inlet valve into the thread, which is sitting tightly against the facepiece opening. Button up the second filter pocket. Make sure the chin part of the cup is properly set and it's not crumpled inside the face piece. Fix the oronasal cup in the position by fastening it against the filter pocket buttons. When you're done, the inside of the mask should look like this. Now it's time to reattach the bottom head harness buckles. Be sure the straps are fastened correctly and are not twisted. One thing no one talks about is the importance of turning the inlet valve grids into the correct downward pointing position to protect the filters against water or drops of water chemical agents. Simply turn the grid clockwise by any suitable tool at hand so the grid is positioned as you can see in the video. Remember how I mentioned different construction of inlet valves in M10 and M10M? In order for the M10's inlet valve grid to turn, you need to release a small spring that holds the grid in its place. This is not the case for the modernized M10M version. When it comes to outsert mounting, here is a simple little trick how to save yourself a lot of time while trying to fit the rubber edges to the lenses. Bend the lower part of the rubber with your fingers and mount the outsert with the upper part going on the lens first. Then simply release the folded lower part of the rubber and it will sit nicely all around the lens. Do the same for the second lens. Lastly, this is not how the drinking tube is supposed to be. It should be carried under this rubber cover which surrounds the exhale chamber. This is the correct way of deploying the drinking tube in the field conditions. Once fluids have been replenished, the drinking tube needs to be put under the rubber cover once again and the drinking port safely closed. And what about this mysterious plastic strip no one knows what it's for? As the masks were supposed to be stored in the plastic bags they came with, this little strip was used to keep the bag closed once the factory seal was broken. That's all for the big reveal, you're welcome! Thanks for watching, like and subscribe and remember to check out the historical episode about the M10N kit once it's out.